A reference field is really simple and enormously powerful. The simple part is that it lets us reference fields from an item in another collection. And here's the powerful part. We have two collections in our project, blog posts and authors. When we write a blog post, we don't want to have to do the bio and the picture and the name for that matter, each and every time we write a new blog post. These are all fields which we could create and populate in our authors collection. Back in our blog posts collection, when we add a reference field, we're simply granting access to the author's collection. And when we're creating a blog post, the reference field will let us select the author in that collection. And how do we build with this? We still build using our blog posts collection, but because we're referencing the author's collection, we can build with those fields as well. You can see that even though we're on the blog posts collection page, we're pulling all this information from the author's collection. We're binding each of these elements to the relevant field in the author's collection, which we can now access because we've selected the collection item, each author, using our reference field. So, reference fields. With them, we can reference fields from items in another collection.